Welcome to Narayana Lab classes. Today we'll be discussing about class 8th social assignment from the chapter Civilizing the Native, Educating the Nation. This is a chapter in history. So here are 11 questions in this assignment. You can answer them either in one or two sentences. Let's see what is the first question here. Name the two individuals who sharply attacked the Orientalist. Orientalists are the one who supported for the Indian or Eastern education. So the people who opposed the Oriental education were James Mill and Thomas Babington Macaulay. James Mill, who wrote the History of British India, and Thomas Babington Macaulay, who introduced the education system, a Western education system for India. These two are the one who strongly opposed or attacked the Orientalist. Let's see the second question. What does madrasa mean? So madrasa is an Arabic word for a place of learning and any type of school or college. Basically, madrasa is associated with the Islamic education. So it means it's an Arabic word where it's a place of learning. That is a common meaning of that word. Let's see the third question. Who is a linguist? A linguist is a person who knows and studies multi-languages or several languages who knows or who studies. They are called as linguist. So William Jones was a linguist because he knew a lot of languages like Persian, English, French, Sanskrit. All these languages he was knowing, so he was called as a linguist. Let's see the fourth question. What does Munshi mean? So Munshi is a person, basically in India, a Munshi is called as a person who knows to read, write and teach Persian. A person who can teach, who can read and who can write Persian is called as a Munshi. Then fifth question, why was madrasa set up in Calcutta in 1781? So the madrasa was set up in Calcutta in 1781 to promote the study of Arabic, Persian and Islamic law. To learn Arabic, Persian and Islamic law, madrasa was set up in 1781 at Calcutta by Nathaniel Halhead and William Jones. Let's see the sixth question. What different languages did William Jones study? I told you he was a linguist. So what are the languages he learned? He was a linguist. He studied Greek, Latin at Oxford, French, English, then Arabic and also Persian. And from Indian pundits he learned even Sanskrit also. So he was a linguist because he knew many languages. Next question. Why was the Hindu college established in Benares? So the Hindu college was established 10 years later the madrasa in Calcutta. Madrasa was in 1781, whereas the Hindu Benares college was set up in 1791. So it was to encourage the study of ancient Sanskrit text or to learn oriental text like the Sanskrit text. It will be very useful for the administration of the country. Let's see the next question. What is meant by Orientalist? So Orientalists are the people or those who are having scholarly knowledge about the language and culture of Asia or who knows about the Eastern education are called as the Orientalist. Then who was William Jones? William Jones was appointed as a junior judge at the Supreme Court by the company. So company appointed William Jones as the junior judge and basically he was a linguist also. Then when and where did the Hindu college was established? So the Hindu college was established at Benares in 1791 with an intention to teach the ancient Sanskrit text. Let's go with the last question of this assignment. What was the aim at education according to James Mill? So according to James Mill, he wanted to teach something useful and practical in their life. And he said that Indians should be familiar with the scientific and technical advances. So scientific knowledge rather than the textual Sanskrit learning like the learning of slokas and all. Instead of that, let them learn something practically and technically which will be useful for their further life. And he made rather than the poetry and secret literature of the Orient. Instead of making the Orient or instead of making poetry or literature, let them learn something which can be practical and technologically useful in their life. That is what the main intention of James Mill. That is why he strongly opposed the Oriental education. So these are the questions in this assignment. Actually, this chapter is quite interesting chapter, which is about our education system, how it got transformed from the ancient teaching system to the present system what we have. That is what detailedly explaining in this chapter. So do this assignment and come back to the next one. Thank you all. Have a good day.